Good morning, Trinity Academy students and family. I'm happy to see you all here today. Our chapel is looking a little bit different. It's a little bit more full, which is good. A couple things you might notice on the order of service is that we have some recognitions that we'd like to take advantage of today, as well as having a special in recitation and also just our general time of worship. And so I'd like to ask Ms. Helmut to come down here. A lot of you know that our archery students have been very active this past season in the fall, and we were able to host an in-house tournament that we are actually going to be sharing those scores and results to another tournament. It's an online tournament, but we have been allowed to participate in this tournament that will have national standing. And though we know what happened here at our house tournament, we are placing everybody on this national tournament level so they can get national recognition, allowing us other opportunities to have in-house tournaments here as well as to go to other tournaments in different towns. And so we're really excited about this. We want to take the time to recognize the hard work that all of our archers put in this year. Everyone shot really, really well. And in fact, it came down to within NAS, National Archery in the Schools program, to determine ties, you base it off of how many bullseyes there are. So we had to do that two different times for both the grammar school as well as the upper school. And so you all should be very proud of the way that you shot. We're gonna be sharing just some of those standings later on. We're gonna post it out so that you can see all standings as we're recognizing first, second, and third place for grammar and upper school today. And I'll leave it to Ms. Helmut.
Okay, so I'm going to announce the grammar school awards first, and then we'll do logic rhetoric. Starting with third place for the grammar school, Nora Young, with a score of 158.
Come on down here. Come on down.
I have something for you.
You can stay up here because I'm sure that we're going to want to get a picture of all of you guys.
All right. In second place for the grammar school, with a score of 166, Thomas Ashwood. And in first place for the grammar school, with a score of 173, Ezra Link. Logic Rhetoric School students, third place for Logic Rhetoric was Ellie Donaldson, who is not here today, but Mr. Stinnett will be passing her award on to her. So in second place then for Logic and Rhetoric with a score of 219, Olin Runyon. All right, and first and second place were really close. This is one of the ones that had to be decided based upon number of bullseyes. In first place, with a score of 219 and double bullseye, Eli Norton. All right. Any teachers want to snap pictures of them real quick, and then I'm going to send them up to their seats. So.
Thank you for allowing us the opportunity to share those awards. I'd like to pray and continue just our time together. And as soon as I'm finished, we're going to have actually fourth grade come up this morning and begin in our time of worship and scripture and song. So let's pray together. Father in heaven, Lord, we thank you that you've granted to us opportunities to gather together to recognize different gifts and talents that you've given to us and also just to celebrate one another. We are very thankful that we have this opportunity as a family that you've called us to be. Lord, in our time this morning of worship, we ask that what we do be pleasing and honorable to you. We ask these things in Jesus' name. Amen. Please welcome fourth grade this morning. Thank you for sharing the scriptures with us this morning. Let's stand as we take this time and sing some songs of praises.
Of glory, the King of stop, you never stop working. You never stop, you never stop working. Even when I don't see it, you're working. Even when I don't feel it, you're working. You never stop, you never stop working. Never stop, you never stop working. Even when I don't see it, you're working. Even when I don't feel it, you're working. You never stop, you never stop working. You never stop, you never stop working. Even when I don't see it, you're working. Even when I don't feel it, you're working. You never stop, you never stop working. You never stop, you never stop. Oh, waymaker, miracle worker, promise keeper, light in the darkness. My God, that is who you are. You are waymaker, miracle worker, promise keeper, light in the darkness. My God, that is who you are. 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 That is who you are.
Sing that again.
That is who you are. That is who you are. That is who you are. That is who you are.
Let's pray. Father in heaven, we thank you that that is who you are. That despite the things that we may see in this world and the things that we face that are difficult and hard, you are never changing. And we thank you for that. We thank you for Boston this morning, the word that you've laid upon his heart. May you give him that confidence, that peace, and knowing that the words that he speaks are the words that you've given to him. And may you be glorified in this time. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen. You may have a seat.
Good morning, Trinity students.
Good morning, Boston.
So today I have three plates here. I'm looking for a volunteer that I'd like to come up and eat what is under plate number one. Trust me, you'll like it. Rayelynn, would you like to come up? Remember, whatever's under this foil, you have to eat it. You don't have to eat all of them, but you can eat as you want. Now I'm looking for a volunteer that I'd like to come up and eat what is under plate number two. Remember, if you come up here, you have to eat whatever is under the plate. Luke Murray. What Luke just ate was sardines and canned spinach. Okay, now I'm looking for one more volunteer that would like to come up and eat what is under plate number three. I can see some of you are having a hard time deciding whether or not you would like to come up and eat what is under plate number three. Our trusting humans changes a lot. We can never be, people are dishonest and don't keep their promises. We can never be 100% sure if we can trust somebody. However, what is reassuring is that our trust in God will remain the same no matter what the circumstance or situation is. The words translated as trust literally mean a bold or confidence or security or action based on that security. There are 191 variations of the word trust written in the Bible. It's important to know that trust is not the same as faith. Trust is what we do because of the faith we have been given. Why is trust important, you may be asking? How many of you were alive when Jesus was born? How many of you were at the tomb when the stone was rolled away and Jesus was no longer there? Not a single one of us in this room was there. We trust that God sent his son to earth. Jesus was born to a virgin named Mary. He brought a dead man back to life. He walked on water. He was crucified and died on a cross. We trust God, the Bible, history books, that Jesus rose from the dead and ascended to heaven. Our December hero is Isaiah. In Isaiah 9:6, it says he prophesied that for us too a son is born, for us a son is given, and the government shall be upon his shoulders. His name shall be called Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace. Our memory verse for December is Luke 2:11, which is, "For unto you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, who is Christ Jesus, Christ the Lord." The prophecy in the Old Testament, in fact, came true. In the book of Isaiah, there are scriptures that are specifically about trust. In Isaiah 12:2, it says, "Behold, God is my salvation. I will trust and will not be afraid. For the Lord God is my strength and my song, and he has become my salvation." Isaiah 26:3-4 says, "You keep him in perfect peace, whose mind is stayed on you, because he trusts in you. Trust in the Lord forever, for the Lord God is an everlasting rock." I know sometimes when you hear a lot of scriptures read out loud, one after the other, it can be easy to tune out. Well, listen to what the book of Psalms says about trust. How about this? Every time you hear the word trust, you will raise your hand and put it back down. Is everyone ready?
Yes.
Let's do a test. Let's look back at play number 3. Trust me, you'll like it. Let's try this again. And I see that a ton of people do it. Let's look back. Every time you hear the word trust, you're going to raise your hand and put it back down. Let's look back at play number 3. Trust me, you'll like it. In Psalms 27, it says, "Some trust in chariots and some in horses, but we trust in the name of the Lord our God." Psalm 37:3 says, "Trust in the Lord and do good. Dwell in the land of and befriend faithfulness." Psalms 43, which was one of our memory verses, says, "He put a new song in my mouth, a song of praise to our God. Many will see and put their trust in the Lord." Psalm 62:8 says, "Trust in him at all times. O people, pour out your heart before him. God is a refuge for us." Psalms 84:12 says, "O Lord of hosts, blessed is the one who trusts in you." There are many more scriptures I could share with you. It is neat to see how much the Bible talks about trusting in the Lord. The Bible tells us when we trust in the Lord, we will be blessed, we will be given mercy and loving kindness, we will have peace, we will be delivered from our enemies, we will be kept from our fear, and my personal favorite, we'll have excitement and joy. So Trinity students, I want to share with you four ways you can trust God more today. Number one is read God's word so that you will know his voice. Two, pray to God often and listen to his response through your heart. Number three, remember God's ways are better than yours. In Psalms 118, it says, it is better to take refuge in the Lord than to trust in man. Look at God, and lastly, number four, look at God's track record in your life. Notice how he has worked in your life. Work on building your trust in the Lord. As you can see, the Bible tells us how important it is. And we can see all the ways it makes our life better. Trust me, you'll like it.
There was nothing under it.
Thank you, Boston. Well, he was right with their being nothing under the plate. Sometimes it's nice just to have an empty plate. But thank you. I appreciate that, Boston. And just a reminder of where we are placing our reliance and our faithfulness into the one who is faithful. We're going to end today with the doxology, and we sing this every day. At least grammar school sings it every day at recitations. And just wanted to finish today with this. Together as one voice. And so will you stand as we sing the doxology together?
Praise God from whom all blessings flow.
Praise you. We thank you for this day you've given to us and the opportunity we have to show and to share for what you have granted to us in terms of the abilities and gifts and talents. But most importantly, Lord, you call us to be people of faith. Help us to walk in faith today. Give us strength and wisdom and discernment to do what you've asked us to do and the responsibilities that are set before us. And may we honor and glorify you in all that we say and do. In Jesus' name, we pray. Amen. I love y'all. You are dismissed. We'll dismiss with pre-K first, and then we'll go to kindergarten.